Hi students, welcome back to my channel. In this video I have explained the shortcut methods to find the pH of the mixtures of acids and the bases, and also discuss the problems on buffers, degree of dissociation of acids and the bases. Enjoy this video and do subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Two solutions A and B, each of 100 liter, was made by dissolving 4 gram of NaOH and 9.8 gram of sulfuric acid in water respectively. The pH of the resultant solution obtained from mixing 40 liters of solution A and 10 liters of solution B is how much? So what they have done is 4 gram of NaOH is dissolved in 100 liters of water solution, and similarly in another container 9.8 gram of sulfuric acid is dissolved in 100 liters of solution, right? So, and then 40 liters of NaOH is taken and mixed with 10 liters of sulfuric acid, and the mixture obtained, in that what is the pH need to be determined. So, for that first we have to know the concentration of NaOH and sulfuric acid in 100 liters of the solution, and then let us find out the number of equivalents of H plus and OH minus ion present in 40 liters of NaOH and 10 liters of sulfuric acid mixture. So first let us find out the concentration of acid and base. So what I will do is I will find out the concentration of this as a normality. Normality of acid is equal to mass of the acid present per liter multiplied by the basicity divided by the molecular mass. If you don't take the basicity, it becomes molarity. If you take the basicity here, it becomes a normality. Then what is this basicity? Basicity of the acid is number of replaceable hydrogen ions. Here it is 2. Similarly, for the base, normality of base is equal to mass of the base present per liter multiplied by the acidity divided by the molecular mass. So then what is acidity? Acidity is number of replaceable hydroxy group present in the compound. Now let us find out the normality of NaOH. How much has been taken? 4 gram. In how many liters it is dissolved? 100 liters. 4 gram present in 100 liters. What is the acidity? Acidity is number of replaceable hydroxyl group, that is equal to 1, divided by the molecular mass, that is equal to 40. So on simplification it gives 1 into 10 raised to minus 3 normal, right? Similarly, if you take sulfuric acid, 9.8 grams of sulfuric acid is taken and dissolved in 100 liter solution, multiplied by the basicity, that is the number of replaceable hydrogen ion, that is equal to 2, divided by the molecular mass, that gives 2 into 10 raised to minus 3. So here we got the concentration as normality. Here normality of acid is more than that of NaOH, but amount of alkali and acid that is taken, this is most important for us, not the solution that we prepared. The mixture that we have is most important. What is that we have taken? 40 liters of A, that is NaOH, is taken, and sulfuric acid is 10 liters. So volume into normality will give the number of equivalents of OH minus ion, that is equal to 4 into 10 raised to minus 2. Similarly, if you multiply the volume by the equivalents of sulfuric acid, that gives the number of hydrogen ions, that is equal to 2 into 10 raised to minus 2. So this is 4 into 10 raised to minus 2, whereas this is 2 into 10 raised to minus 2. Here concentration of hydroxyl ion is more than that of H plus. So that means the solution is alkaline in nature. So in this mixture we need to find out the pH of this liquid. So how you get? So here we know that concentration of NaOH is more than sulfuric acid. So what you get is concentration of hydroxyl ion, that is equal to, the simplest way is N1U1, that is highest equivalent is NaOH minus N1U1 of sulfuric acid divided by volume of NaOH plus volume of acid. Similarly, if other way converse is true, then what you get is you get the concentration of hydrogen ions. That means if acid is more than NaOH, you get the concentration of hydrogen ions. So these are the two shortcut formulas to get the normality of or equivalents of H plus ion and OH minus ion. So this can be used not only for acid base mixture, even for the acids also we can make use of this type of formula. So we'll see it later. Now let us come to this problem. Now here N1U1 of NaOH is more than that of sulfuric acid. So what you get is normality of hydroxyl ion. Substitute for N1U1 and N2V2. On substitution we get the value as, so 4 into 10 raised to minus 2 minus 2 into 10 raised to minus 2, that comes to 0.04 into 10 raised to minus 2. That is the concentration of hydroxylion. So we know the concentration of hydroxylion. So what you get is pOH. pOH is equal to negative log of hydroxylion concentration. Substitute it. Here it can be written as 4 into 10 raised to minus 4. So when the formula is minus log of pOH is equal to minus log of 4 into 10 raised to minus 4, that can be written as A into 10 raised to minus C. So this can be written as C minus of log A. So 10 minus minus log of 10 raised to minus C becomes positive C. So here this 10 raised to 4 minus 4 becomes 4. So that is pOH is equal to 4 into 4 minus of log 4. 4 minus of log 4. So remember this. So this is nothing but log A plus log B. On simplification you get C minus of log A, because log 10 is equal to 1, right? And so simplified here, on simplification log 4 is equal to 0.6021. simplification you get 3.39. so this can be taken as 3.4. so pOH is known. Substitute in the formula pH plus pOH is equal to 14. So then pH is equal to 14 minus pOH. pOH is 3.4. so answer is 10.6. the pH of this mixture is 10.6. so 10.6 is the answer for this problem. So this carries 4 marks. Remember, numericals will carry 4 marks. Even if the answer is wrong, you don't lose marks here. So it is very good to attend numericals. So these are the two shortcut methods, right? One, depending upon the concentration of acid or base, which one is more. So on the basis of that, you can get the either normality of hydroxylion, that is equivalence of hydroxylion, or hydrogen ion. So if hydrogen ion, to get this, concentration of or equivalence of acid should be more than that of alkali. So these are the two shortcut routes to find out the solution for this type of problems. Now let us see another question which has appeared in another examination, that is NEET 2018, and which is on the same lines as for that of previous one. And the following solutions were prepared by mixing different volumes of NaOH and HCl of different concentrations. So there are given 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4 combinations of acid and base. And from that, what is that? pH of which of them is equal to 1. That need to be identified. So which solution, 1, 2, 3, 4 among them, which solution, which mixtures pH is equal to 1, as that has to be identified. So how to do this? So for that you have to know the concentration of the solution. So here pH is equal to 1 means what? The hydrogen ion concentration, right? How do you know that if pH is equal to 1 for a solution, if when the pH value is less than 7, then in that case, if the pH is equal to x, then hydrogen ion concentration is equal to 10 raised to minus x. So here x is equal to 1, so that means hydrogen ion concentration is 10 raised to minus 1. So required solution, we need a solution wherein which the pH has to be 1. So that means the hydrogen ion concentration is equal to 10 raised to minus 1. That we have to find out. So we have to find out the concentration of the mixture in which, in that mixture, amount of acid should be more, and it should be more in such a way that it is equal to 10 raised to minus 1. That's what we have to do. We have to apply the same formula which you have applied in the previous case. So for that we have to know the assess the system here, situation here. What is that? In this mixture, right? Find out the mixture of the molar mixture, concentration of the mixture, right? So that's what we have to find out, such that it is equal to 10 raised to minus 1. So formula is, normality of mixture should be equal to H plus is equal to concentration of H plus is equal to N2V2 minus N1U1, where N2V2 is should be more than N1U1. That is, normality of acid should be more than that of NaOH. So NaOH concentration should be less. So how do you know this? No, see this here. In all these cases, in each set, acids and bases are same. What is that? Concentrations of acids are base. Here N by 10, here also M by 10. M by 10, M by 10. M by 5, M by 5. M by 10, M by 10. Concentration is same. Then volume of bases, acids, in both, in all the case, in all each set, 60, 40. This is more. 50, 45. Acid more. 75, 25 acid more. 100, 100. So except this. So in 1, 2, 3, amount of acid is more. Concentration same, but acid is more. That means this is acidic mixture. The concentration of this acid is more than that of alkali. So the concentrations of acids are 1, 2, 3 is more than that of alkali. And look at this. In this case, concentration is same, volume is same. So when you mix the same concentration of acid and base, it becomes a neutral solution. 4 becomes a neutral solution. You can directly eliminate because amount of acid is equal to amount of base. Since acid and bases are strong electrolytes, they completely neutralize to give salt and water. So fourth expression will be the completely neutral solution whose pH will be 7, right, at 298 Kelvin of course. Now, so we know that concentration of acids are more than that of base. So let us try one by one, first one. So now take the first equation. So N1V1, acid is more than that of base, M1, the concentration is 1 by 10, that's equal to 0.1, multiplied by 60 minus 0.1 into 40. So simplify this, on simplification you get 2 into 10 raised to 2, that is not equal to H plus. So first one is ruled out. Second one, simplify the same manner, on simplification, the H plus ion becomes 1 into 10 raised to minus 2, this also ruled out, 1 and 2 is ruled out. So fourth one is also ruled out. So possible answer is third. Okay, let us verify that. So here we have eliminated this because this will give the neutral solution. 1 and 2 checked, that doesn't give. So obviously third one, let us verify it. In this third case, concentration of this is 75 divided by 1 by 5 into 25 divided by 1 by 5. That becomes 75 with this, 7, this will be 15 minus 5. 15 minus 5 is 10, 10 by 100. 10 by 100 is nothing but 10 raised to minus 1. So H plus N is equal to 10 raised to minus 1. So answer is third one. Third one is the answer. This is the correct answer for this question. So this is how we can arrive at the answer. Right? So this has appeared in NEET 2018. So the answer is third answer. This is the third. So here it is. It is D. Answer is D is the correct answer. And similarly, if pOH less than 7, the same case, if pOH is equal to X, then the concentration of hydroxylene is equal to. Now let us see another tricky question that will appear in the examination. It has appeared in the examination. It was in KCET 2016. The pH of 10 minus 8 molar HCl is. You have to calculate the pH of 10 minus 8 molar HCl solution. Yes, this is the common mistake most of the students will commit. So here they have given the concentration of expression that is equal to 10 raised to minus 8. Since concentration of pH is equal to negative log of hydrogen ion concentration, that is hydrogen ion concentration is 10 raised to minus 8. Normally, student write the answer for this as, so if log of pH is equal to 10 raised to minus 8, pH is equal to 8. This is the answer they normally write, but actually this is wrong. This is not correct. Why? The reason is, if the concentration of H plus or OH minus ion of acid or base is less than 10 raised to minus 7, minus 6 moles, that means it could be 10 raised to minus 7, 8, 9, 10, etc. Then the contribution by ionization of water to be considered, contribution of H plus and OH minus obtained by the ionization of water to be considered. So since this concentration is less than 10 raised to minus 3, so we have to take the ionization of water also into considerations. So now let us see how much it is. Mind you, this is not equal to 8 by simple direct formula of negative logarithm of hydrogen ion concentration. So here hydrogen ion obtained from this solution is, say it is 10 raised to minus 8. Then what will be the amount of hydrogen ion obtained by the ionization of water? For that we have to know the ionic product of water. Ionic product of water is equal to concentration of hydrogen ion and hydroxylene, that is equal to 10 raised to minus 4 at 25 degrees Celsius. So here amount of hydrogen ion and hydroxylene are same, and that is equal to 10 raised to minus 7 mole per day cube. So amount of hydrogen ion from water is 1 into 10 raised to minus 7 moles. So add these two, hydrogen from HCl and hydrogen ion from water. So when you add these two, so total hydrogen ion will be hydrogen ion from HCl and then that of water. So that will be 1 into 10 raised to minus 8 plus 1 into 10 raised to minus 7. So this 10 raised to 1 into 10 raised to minus 8 can be written as 0.1 into 10 raised to minus 7. This also in 10 raised to minus 7 form. So take the common factor, it comes to 1.1 into 10 raised to minus 7 mole. That is the hydrogen ion concentration. Now you have taken hydrogen ion from water and that of HCl, which is there in the solution. So from this directly, calculate the pH. pH is equal to negative log of hydrogen ion concentration. Hydrogen ion concentration is 1.1 into 10 to minus 7. So simplify this again, A into B log plus A into 10 to the power of 7 minus 7. So this will be psi 7 minus 7 means it will be 7 log minus log of 1.1. So see the logarithm for 11. 11 is equal to 0.0414. So on subtraction you will be getting 6.9586. So the value is less than 7. So value is between 6 and 7. 8 is not that, 6 and 7. So C is the correct answer, but not the 8. So you have to be very, very careful when they give the concentration of hydrogen or hydroxyl ion is less than 10 raised to minus 6. So this is a clue and this is very important. So that's why I have taken this question. Okay. So let us see another question which is separate in case CET 2012. So here 5 ml of 0.4 normal NaOH is mixed with 20 ml of 0.4 normal HCl. pH of the resulting solution is, for this direct solution is multiply this normality into equivalent, right? So how much it is? 4 into 5 is 0.8, it becomes 2, and here also 20 into 0.1, it also becomes 2. So now here number of equivalents is 2, this also equal to 2. So when acid and base, the equivalents of acid and base are same, that means acid will be completely neutralized by the base. So at the end, we end up in the neutral solution. So pH of the resulting solution is 7. So this is a shortcut method. Multiply the normality into equivalent, put normality into the volume, that gives the number of equivalents. If acid alkali equivalents is equal to acids equivalents, then it will be perfectly neutral solution. So that's why I told you to take the normality rather than the molarity, because one equivalent is equal to one equivalent of acid, one equivalent of base is equal to one equivalent of acid. So that will be the one equivalent of salt solution. So that is how you can arrive at the answer. So these are very important and tricky questions, right? And these are the very, very trickier one, right? Now I will give another example of the students where normally they commit blunders. And this is the question appeared in AIPMT 2015. What is the pH of the resulting solution when equal volumes of 0.1 molar NaOH with 0.01 molar HCl are mixed? While reading the question, what the student will normally commit mistake is, while reading they rate it as equal volumes of 0.1 molar NaOH with 0.1 molar HCl are mixed. So 0.1 molar of HCl and NaOH both are same. But this also 0.1, this also 0.1. So that means acid will be completely neutral with the base. So that means you will get a neutral solution. The solution is neutral and the pH will be 7. So unfortunately answer A is 7. So immediately they conclude that A is the correct answer. So this is mainly because of overconfidence and a blunder in reading the question. If improper reading is there, then it can lead to errors. So please read the questions carefully. Here equal volumes of 0.1 molar NaOH is made to react with 0.01 molar of HCl. That means HCl concentration is less than that of NaOH. So this mixture will be excess of NaOH, will be having excess of NaOH. That means it will be alkaline solution. So apply our same methodology, right? This is the normality of mixture is equal to N1U1 minus N2V2, where N1U1 will be the concentrations of this one NaOH, right? Here V1 is not given, you take this as a V. So equal volume is V, so 0.1 V minus 0.01 V divided by V plus V. The V1 plus V2 is V plus V. Simplify it will be 0.09 V divided by 2 V. V cancels, then it will be hydroxyl ion concentration is 0.045. And do the simplification and calculate the pOH. After knowing the pOH, know the pH. pH is equal to 14 minus pOH. So that gives the value as 12.65. Another answer here itself, you get a clue that once you know that this NaOH is an excess, that means the pH will always be greater than 7. So here among the answers 1, 2, 3, so the C is the one which is a alkaline. So from this itself you can directly say C is the correct answer, right? That will be the clue here itself, clue there. So another question is, pH of which of the following solution is not equal to 1? pH is not equal to 1 means what? The hydrogen ion concentration not equal to 0.1, that is 10 raised to minus 1. pH 1 means 10 raised to minus 1. H plus is 10 raised to minus 1. 0.1 mole of acetic acid. Acetic acid is a weak electrolyte, that means it will not. 0.1 means it is already 10 raised to minus 1. This do not dissociate completely, that means
This cannot be, hydrogen and concentration cannot be equal to 10 raised to minus 1. This itself is the answer. But let us verify here. So B is 0.1 mole of HNO3 completely dissociates here to give 0.1 mole of hydrogen ion. So that means this is BHS1. Whereas here it is 0.05, right? Again, this is another mistake. It's a molar. So we have to convert it to equivalents. For that, multiply this 0.05 by number of replaceable hydrogen, that is 2. So 2 into 0.05 is 0.1. So that is again 0.1 normal HCl. That will be 0.1 normal of 0.1 hydrogen ion, that is equal to pH1. And here volume into this one, what is that molarity? When you multiply, you will get 2 here. This will be 10. So 2 here, 20 here, 10. 20 minus 10 is 10. 10 by 100 is so again 0.1. So answer is 0.1. So this is the 0.1 mole of stick acid does not give the pH 1, right? So be careful while answering these questions, right? Because here another mistake the committee is 0.05 means, oh, this will be the correct answer, right? So simply take 0.1. So this means 10 raised to minus 1. So they eliminate this and they may declare C as the answer. So these two questions are the one which could be, it may go wrong because of wrong reading and wrong calculations.
Now solve this question. The clue for this is this question has been given. There are two acids and one base is there in the mixture, and the mixture has been diluted to 1 dm cube, and for this mixture you have to find out the pH of the resulting solution. Here molarity is equal to normality because these are all monobasic acids and monoacidic bases. So molarity will be equal to normality. So number of equivalents is equal to normality into the volume, right? So the same earlier formula, that is the simplest formula that we used to give, right? So if the acid concentration, hydrogen ion concentration is more than that of base, then this is the formula. If acid is more, you get the normality of hydrogen ion. From that you can calculate the pH directly. And N1U1 and N2B2 are the concentrations of equivalents of acid and HCl and HNO3. And if this is more than NaOH, you get the hydrogen ion. If the other way around, if the concentration of acid is less than base, you get the hydroxyl ion concentration. From that also you can get the pH. And here the total volume is, the net volume is 1 dm cube. And here V1, V2, V3, right, the sum of the volumes is not 20 plus 30, 20 and 40, but it is 1 dm cube. Total volume is equal to 1 dm cube. You can express in terms of Cc, and that will give the hydrogen ion or hydroxyl ion. That depends upon the concentration of N1, V1 plus N2, V2. And you can do the problem for yourself, right? So answer for this is 2. You have to get the 2 as the answer. So shortcut method is given. So this is the shortcut method. N1 U1 plus N2 V2 minus N1 N3 V3 to total volume. So if acid concentration is for the base. Do it for yourself. Now let us take the numerical which has appeared in 2020 JEE 2020, and here 3 grams of acetic acid is added to 250 ml of 0.1 molar hydrochloric acid. And the solution made up to 500 ml. So after dissolution, this solution has been made up to 500 ml by adding water. To 20 ml of this mixture, right, 1 by 2 ml of 5 molar NaOH is added. The pH of the solution is how much, that we have to calculate. So they have given the acid mixture and NaOH, mixture of acid, two acids and NaOH. And also pKa of acetic acid is given. Molar mass of acetic acid is given, log 3 value is given, and neglect any changes in volume after neutralization. Whatever the change that has happened, to neglect that. Now let us see what can happen here is. So here, the acid which is present here is, this acetic acid is a weak electrolyte. So this cannot dissociate completely. That means concentration of acetic acid will not be equivalent to hydrogen ion concentration because dissociation is not 100%. Whereas in these two cases, HCl and NaOH, that is 100% dissociation. So we cannot use the earlier shortcut method to determine the pH of the solution, right? So in such cases, we have to assess the scenario properly. Now here, what can happen is, right, if the NaOH is more than HCl, it will neutralize the HCl completely. And then remaining after the neutralization, if the NaOH present here is not just sufficient to completely neutralize acetic acid, then what can happen is, all the NaOH which is left over after neutralization of HCl can neutralize some amount of acetic acid to give sodium acetate and leaving some amount of unreacted acetic acid. So as a result of that, there will be the presence of weak acid, that is acetic acid, and its salt in the mixture. So So if there is a weak acid and its salt is present, then that can act as a buffer. Since pKa is given, there is a possibility of formation of buffer, and that is possible only when this NaOH is not completely sufficient to neutralize both the acid. It neutralizes one, that is HCl, completely, but not completely. But not this acetic acid will not be neutralized completely. So it will be partial. So that is possible. So now for that we need to know the concentrations of these solutions. First, let us take the acetic acid. How much it has been taken? 3 grams of acetic acid is taken and made to dissolve in 500 ml. Though it is dissolved here in 250 and then diluted to 500 ml, its net volume is 500 ml. So here molarity of acetic acid is equal to mass of the acid divided present in 1 liter. Here 3 grams of acetic acid present in 500 ml. So then 1000 ml contains how much? That will be double of this. 1000 ml is equal to 1 liter. So 3 into 2 divided by 60 is the molecular mass. That gives the molarity of this acetic acid. But 1 liter or 500 ml of acetic acid is not taken here. How much is taken? 20 ml. In this 20 ml of this mixture, how much acetic acid is there? That can be known by multiplying this molarity of the acetic acid with volume of the solution that is taken. That gives the number of equivalents of acetic acid. M is 0.1. Volume is 20 ml. So when you do that, you will be getting two equivalents of acetic acid. So we know the equivalents of acetic acid. Let us see HCl and NaOH. HCl is so much 0.1 molar, but it is diluted to 500 ml. So volume has been doubled. So when you double the volume, the concentration will become half, that we have told in the previous videos also. Where half of the 0.1 is 0.05, that is direct substitution. Or else conventionally you can calculate M1 V1 is equal to M2, we need to find out, V2 is 500 ml. So if you substitute for that, you will be getting the concentration of HCl as 0.05, that is by the conventional method. So here that is the concentration, but we have not taken 500 ml of the mixture. What you have taken is 20 ml. In that 20 ml, how much HCl is there? That is again molarity into volume of the solution taken, that is 0.05 into 20, that comes to 1 equivalent. So 1 equivalent of hydrochloric acid, 2 equivalents of acetic acid is present. Now let us see how many equivalents of NaOH is there. Number of equivalents of NaOH is equal to molarity into volume. Volume is 1 by 2, that is 0.5 into 5, it comes to 2.5 equivalents. Now what are possible? NaOH can react with both HCl and acetic acid. How much HCl is there? 1 equivalent. How much NaOH is there? 2.5 equivalent. So first it will react. Because both are strong electrolytes, they react completely. Since NaOH is more, how much is there? 2.5 equivalents. It will completely neutralize all the HCl to give sodium chloride and water. So HCl is completely gone. What is left over? Out of 2.5, one mole is gone with HCl. Left over is 1.5 moles of NaOH. Then what will happen? This NaOH, which is present in excess, reacts with the weak acid, that is acetic acid. When it reacts, this reacts. How much of NaOH is there? NaOH present here is lesser than acetic acid. As I told you, NaOH present is not completely sufficient to neutralize all the acid present in the mixture. So that means here only 1.5 moles of equivalents of NaOH is there. That will neutralize 1.5 equivalents of acetic acid to give 1.5 equivalents of sodium acetate. So out of 2 equivalents of acetic acid, 1.2 equivalents of acetic acid combines with 1.5 equivalents of NaOH to give 1.5 equivalents of sodium acetate. So then how much of acetic acid is left over? 2 minus 1.5, that is 0.5 equivalents of acetic acid is there and 1.5 equivalents of NaOH is there. So you have the salt of weak acid. You have the salt of weak acid. You have weak acid as well as the salt of weak acid, and this will form a buffer. It will form a buffer. So here, since it is a weak acid, so pH of the solution is equal to pH is equal to pKa plus log of salt to acid. What is the salt concentration? 1.5. That of acid is 5. And pKa is given 4.75. Substitute 1.5 by 0.5 is equal to that is equal to 3. Log 3 is given. Substitute for that. On substitution, you will be getting 5.2271 as the pH of this solution. So here, so understand the conditions which is given there, and the basis of the given data, understand it properly and then find out the solution. So analysis of the question is most important and very essential also. Now let us see the next question. Question is, 0.1 mole of 30 ml sodium carbonate reacts with 25 ml HCl. Then how much volume of HCl is required to completely neutralize 0.2 molar 30 ml NaOH? Now let us see the nature of these materials. Sodium carbonate is a diacidic base. HCl is monobasic acid. NaOH is monoacidic base. So here, this is a diacidic base. That means 1 mole is equivalent to 2 equivalents. It is equivalent to 2 equivalents. So that means the number of equivalents of alkali which is present here will be equal to concentration, that is 0.1, multiplied by the volume, that is 30, multiplied by 2, right? So that comes to 0.1 into 30 into 2, that's equal to 6 equivalents. So 6 equivalents of base always be neutralized by 6 equivalent of HCl. That means this 25 ml of unknown normal molar HCl is equal to 6 equivalents. So this is 6 equivalent of HCl. Now let us see how much of equivalents of NaOH is there. Since it is a monoacidic base, so number of equivalents is equal to only 1, whereas here it is 2. So 0.2 into 30 is 6 equivalents. So NaOH present is 6 equivalent. This is also 6 equivalent. This is also 6 equivalent. 6 equivalent of sodium carbonate reaction, 25 equivalents of 25 ml of HCl. Therefore, 6 equivalent of NaOH reacts with 25 ml of HCl. 25 is the answer. This is the shortcut method. So conventionally calculate, so as again the same method, right? So that is equivalent to HCl. So you simplify this here. So 2 into 0.1 into 30, N2 is equal to 25. You calculate this on calculation, normality or molar is equal to 0.24. So then this you can take it as normality. This is because one equivalent of hydrogen ion is there. So this is equal to 6 equivalents. I am expressing in terms of equivalents. Okay. Then so this is equal to 6 equivalents. So whereas this also, this is equal to 6 equivalents and HCl is also equal to 6 equivalents. So 0.1 mole of 1 molar 30 ml sodium carbonate is equal to 6 equivalents of alkali. So that is equal to this 25 ml of HCl, that is also equal to 6 equivalent. When you multiply the normality of HCl with this, that also comes to 6 equivalent. So if you calculate the number of equivalents of NaOH, that also comes to 6 equivalents. So that will be equal to 6 equivalent of HCl. So here what is important is how many equivalents. Number of equivalents of alkali should be equal to number of equivalents of acids, right? So that's what it will matter here. So both right hand side and left hand side should have the same number of equivalents. So then it will satisfy the answer. Now next, let us take another question. This is appeared in the same 2019 JEE examination. What is the pH of the rainwater? What is the approximate rainwater, pH of the rainwater? So here the information, this is 5.6. It is because of the dissolved carbon dioxide, oxides of carbon, basically carbon dioxide, oxides of sulfur and nitrogen. So pH of rainwater is slightly acidic. It is, please remember, the pH of rainwater is 5.6. Let us take the next question. Consider the following statements. The pH of a mixture containing 400 ml of 0.1 molar sulfuric acid and 400 ml of 0.1 molar NaOH will be approximately 1.3. Ionic product of water is temperature dependent, that is true. A monobasic acid with Ka is equal to 10 raised to minus 5 has pH is equal to 5. The degree of dissociation of this acid is 50%. We need to verify and calculate. Lee Shetley's principle is not applicable to common ion effect. Actually, it is applicable to common ion effect. So, this is wrong. This statement is wrong actually. So, the correct statements are, what are the correct statements we need to identify? So, here the fourth statement is wrong, that is clear, right? Okay. Then the correct statements we have to identify. Is it 1, 2, 3 or 1, 2 or 2, 4? Oh, no, 2, 4, 4 is not right. So, this C is ruled out. So, we have to identify which one is this. Now, here in this process, one thing we have to remember, you can look at this, volume is same. Here also volume of the base is same. Acid is same, this also same. So, volume into the normal concentration will give the number of equivalents. 400 into 1, 0.1 is 40, this also 40. 40, 40 means acid is same as that of base. So, that means when the acid concentration is same as that of base, complete neutralization takes place to give neutral solution. So, thus pH may not be equal to 1.3, it may be 7. So, that means this statement could be declared as wrong, but I cannot take it because of to first statement, could be taken as wrong. So when that is the case, then 1, 2, 3, the A, B, C is ruled out by the law of elimination. Only possible is 2 and 3, right? So we may declare that 2 and 3, the D is the correct answer, but actually it is not. So look at this. The sulfuric acid is a dibasic acid. So here, this acid is equal to 2 equivalents of H plus. That means when you are multiplying the concentration and volume, you have to multiply this by 2. So then only number of equivalents will be equal to the number of hydrogens which is present therein. So that is equal to 2 into 400.1, that comes to 80 equivalents. Okay, then that of NaOH is 40 equivalents. So amount of acid is more than that of NaOH. So use our earlier shortcut method, normality of the mixture, right? will give since acid is more, normality of mixture will give the hydrogen ion concentration, that is equal to N2V2 of acid minus N1V1 of the base divided by V1 plus V2. So that is equal to 80 minus 40 divided by 400 plus 400. Simplify that. So that gives the hydrogen ion concentration. So this is nothing but 0.05. This becomes 5 into 10 raised to minus 2. So simplify that. Log of this is equal to 2 minus log 5, that is equal to 2 minus 0.6990, that comes to 1.3. So approximately this is equal to 6.699 can be taken as 7. Okay, so that is equal to approximately, as this is 1.3. So first statement is correct, that is correct. Ionic product of water is definitely temperature dependent, that is correct. Okay, and third one we need to assess, what is that? Monobasic acid, Ka. So take a monobasic acid, okay, and this is a weak acid. When it is a weak, because when you say that 10 raised to minus 5, it is a weak acid, it dissociates to A minus and H plus. Okay, then the Ka for this is, you know that C minus C alpha is the amount of HA which will be present at equilibrium, gives raise to, when out of C, that is initial concentration of HA, C alpha will dissociate to you, C alpha concentrations moles of A minus and C alpha concentration moles of H plus. So on simplification you get Ka is equal to C alpha square by 1 minus alpha. This you should remember. Okay, this actually this is C square alpha square divided by C minus C alpha. If you take the C common factor, this you get cancels, you will end up with this. So here we know the Ka value is 10 raised to minus 5. But at the same time, C alpha is equal to concentration of H plus ion. It is equal to concentration of H plus ion, and that is also given. What is that? pH is equal to 5 means pH is equal to 5 is nothing but hydrogen concentration is 10 raised to minus 5. So that is the hydrogen concentration, which is equal to C alpha. Simplify it. So if you simplify that, 10 raised to minus 5 is equal to 10 raised to minus 5 into this. So cancel this one another. So you will be getting 1 is equal to A alpha by 1 minus alpha. Simplify this. When you simplify, alpha will become 0.5. 0.5 is nothing but 5 divided by 100, that is equal to 50%. Okay. So this will be 50%. Okay. Degree of dissociation is 50%. That is also correct. 1, 2, 3 is correct. And already I told you that Le Chatelier principle will be followed by the common ion effect. It will be applicable to common ion effect. So fourth one is wrong. 1, 2, 3 are correct. So answer is, which one? B is the answer. So this is the correct answer. So analyze the questions properly, understand it very thoroughly, and then answer it. So this is a very tricky question. Next question. The average concentration of sulfur dioxide in the atmosphere over a city on a certain day is 10 ppm. When the average temperature is 298 Kelvin, given the solubility of SO2 in water at 298 Kelvin is 1.3653 mole per liter and pKa of S2SO3, that is sulfurous acid, is 1.92, estimate the pH of rain on that day. So what they have given is amount of sulfur dioxide, that is partial pressure of sulfur dioxide in the atmosphere is 10 ppm. So 10 ppm is parts per million. So that means 10 parts per 1 million parts of it. 10 parts per 1 million parts of it. So it's also equal to 10 milligram per liter. Then what is the solubility? Solubility of the SO2 is, so that will be equal to, SO2 that could be present in the solution will be equal to 10 ppm times of this. So that means 10 ppm is nothing but 10 into 10 raised to minus 6 is 10 raised to minus 5. times of 1.3653 mole per liter will be the what sulfur dioxide in the solution. So in the, if that is the case, then we have to find out the pH of the solution. So when sulfur dioxide dissolved in water, it gives H2SO3, that is sulfurous acid. H2SO3 is a sulfurous acid. So the pKa of this acid is 1.92. It is more than 1. So that means, so dissociation is almost complete. It is completely dissociate. H2SO4 will completely dissociate. That means all the H2SO4 which is present there will be completely converted to what? Hydrogen ion. So what is the concentration of this SO2? SO2 is equal to 1.3653. That will be converted to the H2SO3. Right? Once H2SO3 is formed, that will be completely dissociated to give hydrogen ion. Hydrogen ion concentration is same as the concentration of acid. So that is 1.3653 into 10 raised to minus 5. So you know the concentration of hydrogen ion. Calculate the pH of the solution. So that is 5 minus log of 1.3653. So do that simplification. On simplification, the pH of the solution comes out to be, this particular solution is 4.86. Remember, already I have given the pH of rainwater is 5.6, right? But for this particular case, it is 4.86. So this has appeared long back, but it could be a possible question, right? It involves both the dissociation pKa and solubility of all the factors. Next question. The species present in a solution where carbon dioxide is dissolved in water, or it's more similar to this because the carbon dioxide is present in, right, and that can dissolve in water to give the corresponding carbonic acid. So what are the species that will present in water? So when CO2 dissolves in water, it gives carbonic acid. H2CO3 is carbonic acid. It is acidic in nature. It can form a salt, right? So the water can contain carbon dioxide. Very good example is coke, etc. So that is carbonated water. So carbon dioxide could be present in water, right? And also H2CO3, that is carbonic acid. HCO3 minus, when it ionizes, gives bicarbonate ion, and this is carbonate ion. So all these are present. Carbon dioxide, carbonic acid, HCO3 minus, and carbonate is all carbonate ion, all are possible in the solution. This is only bicarbonate and bicarbonate and carbonate. No, both carbonic acid will also be there. Carbonic acid and carbonate. Here carbon dioxide and carbonic acid. No, all this. So the answer is A for this. So answer is A. Now these are the questions that you can solve. 10 normal and 4 normal HCl required to make 1 liter of, what are the this 10 normal and 4 normal HCl required to make 1 liter of 7 normal HCl. So how much is required? So number of equivalent of, you need to prepare 7 normal solution, how much? 1 liter. So N1, this is N1V1, and this is N2V2, and this is N3V3. So number of equivalents of this picture should be equal to this. So here high and low concentration, and it is in between. So number of equivalents of this picture is equal to number of equivalents of this. So you can do on yourself, right? So try it out. And then the 20 ml of 0.5 normal HCl and 35 ml of 0.1 normal NaOH are mixed. The resulting solution is neutral, basic. It turns phenolphthalein solution pink. That means it is alkaline more than 7, it is 8. And turn methyl orange red, it is between 3 to 4. So here, number of equivalents of acid and number of equivalents of base, find out. So which one is more, on the basis of it, you can tell whether it will be turn the phenolphthalein pink or basic or methyl orange or neutral. That also you can do. Next, 10 cm cube of 1 or 0.1 normal monobasic acid requires 15 cm cube of sodium hydroxide. Solution, whose normality is? What is the normality? N1V1 is equal to N2V2. You can simplify and find out. The next is 0.023 grams of sodium metal is reacted with 100 cm cube of water. The pH of the resulting solution. Mind you, when sodium reacts with water, it gives sodium hydroxide solution. So whatever the NaOH which is there, it will be completely converted to NaOH. Find out the concentration of NaOH, multiply by volume, you will get the number of equivalents. And from the number of equivalents, you can get the pOH. From the pOH, you can calculate pH. On adding which of the following, pH of 20 ml of 0.1 normal HCl will not alter. So which one will not alter, you have to find out. So these are all the questions for yourself. Do it. And these are do it for yourself questions. Find out the answers. The answers are given here. And find out the method for doing that. Dear friends, this is the time for you to ask questions. Please feel free to ask questions. Don't have any inhibitions. So please like this video, share with your friends, and subscribe to my channels. Thank you very much. This has been a nice time with you. Please let me know if you have any questions. Wish you all the best. Thank you very much.